Hi, this is David McCann for WebTNG. In this video, I'm looking at two totally free plugins that you might find useful. The first one is called FluentComments, and it just came out with a new version. It's a plugin that helps you make the native WordPress, the core comment system, a little bit nicer. The second plugin is called User Toolkit. It's useful for managing users if you have a membership site. This video is sponsored by Breakdance, the modern visual website builder for WordPress. It's easy for beginners to learn and powerful enough for the most advanced professionals. Breakdance is loaded with features, including a premium template library, a robust form builder, AI content writing capabilities, a versatile pop-up builder, and seamless WooCommerce integration. Whether you're just starting your WordPress journey or you're a seasoned pro looking for a better builder for your agency, now is the perfect time to build better websites with Breakdance. Try it today and experience the Breakdance difference. So here's the page for FluentComments in the WordPress plugin directory. Okay, you can see that it has Ajax comments. I think a lot of themes might offer that now. But there are three nice features this plugin offers. The first is spam protection. It says advanced cryptographic mechanism. Basically, the claim is that it's almost impossible for a bot to leave a spam comment. If someone manually goes and comments, you know, it will get through, but it'll stop bot comments. The second feature is it allows you to send emails in addition to what WordPress sends by default. Okay, so you can notify a user when their comment's been approved or when other people have commented, you know, in the thread. And the third feature is that the emails that are sent are more attractive than the default WordPress emails. Okay, let's go take a look at that. I have a testing site here. If we go to plugins, you know, here's FluentComments. First, actually, let's go and let's take a look at the comment form. This is what the default Cadence comment form looks like. You know, I'm logged in here, so it knows that. This is another browser where I'm not logged in. Okay, so this is what it looks like for a non-logged in user. Okay, you need to add your name and email, and website is optional. Now I'm going to go back and let's go to the plugins and let's activate this. And when you activate FluentComments, you get the settings screen under the comments menu item. Okay, so here are the settings. You choose which post types you want to use it on. You see it's only showing posts, but look, I have audiobooks and book authors, two custom post types here. And that's because if we go to the post types and we go to the settings, you'll see comments aren't enabled. If I turn that on, and then we go back, now there's the option to use FluentComments there as well. Now this is that spam protection I was talking about. That's one of the main features of the plugin. Then these are the email notifications. You send an email to the commenter when a comment is approved. You send an email to participants of the thread when someone replies to a comment. And you send an email to the post author when a comment is posted. This is, I think, the only one that's a default WordPress option. Okay, so these other two are additional options. If we go back now to our post and add a comment. Okay, Okay, I don't have to put any information in because I'm already logged in. So we're doing this just kind of to see what it looks like. But if we go now in Firefox in another browser to that, we see, okay, here is that. So let's reply to that. And yes, great post. All right. You know, here it says your comment is awaiting moderation, so that's nice. You can see also that the comment form is a little bit different. It's laid out a little bit tighter. You have this little reply item here. So a little reply icon link here. It's similar, but you know, it's a little bit nicer. Let's go and back and let's go to comments. And here's the one that's waiting approval. We approve it. Okay, and here is what a default WordPress email looks like. Okay, so it's not very exciting. All right, this is what that same type of email looks like when you're sending it with FluentComments approved. You see it's formatted much nicer. Then this is the email that the user got when they added their comment. You know, it tells them their comment's been approved and is live. Thank you. We appreciate your contributing to the conversation. So on. Okay. So the emails are nicer also. That's this plugin here, FluentComments. It's one of those plugins that just focuses on doing one thing and doing it well. So now let's go look at the second plugin. This one is called User Toolkit. You can see it's got more than 100 active installs. This plugin is useful for managing users on a membership site. It's got a few features here. You can disable a user. You can switch to view the site as a user. You know, the admin can view a site as a user. It has REST API support if you want to create reports about the last login. Okay, so let's go to the site, to plugins. Before we activate it, let's look at the list of users. What we see here is the user, edit, delete, view, send, password, reset, the name, the email, their role, and the number of posts. Okay, so now let's go and activate this. Okay, and we'll go back now to the user list. And we have the username, the person's name, their email, role, and posts. Those were the columns in the default. But here there's also the option to switch to. That's new. And then there's the option you can deactivate a user without deleting them or changing their password or anything. So that's useful if you have a membership site and you want to pause a user or for some reason stop them from logging in without deleting them. And so these extra fields you can enable or remove using the screen options there. Okay, so I'm logged in as me, as David. Let's go now and switch to another user. This is someone with the subscriber role. This is useful for testing what the admin looks like. I don't have many plugins installed here, but it's not uncommon for plugins to even show menu items, even to subscribers. They haven't set up the filtering correctly. Or here you have these dashboard widgets, but you might not want your users to see them, so you know to disable those. And maybe if you've created a user profile or front-end dashboard for users or your community site, you want to see what it looks like from a user perspective. This switching to a user is helpful. And then there's a link in the admin here to go back. So I'm going to switch back. Okay, so that's the user toolkit. We've looked at Fluent Comments and we've looked at User Toolkit. So these are two plugins that enhance the default features of WordPress Core. Now you know about them in case you need them. Hope you found the video interesting. And if you did, please give it a like and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching.